My name is Bill Melvin, and I am one of the three deputy directors for research. I'm the director of the Sensors and Intelligence Systems Directorate. I came to GTRI fresh out of the Air Force, and I came here because I knew GTRI people, and I really liked the values that they portrayed and the type of work. And I knew I wanted to be close to academia, but I also knew I wanted to focus on classified research in support of national defense. In the portfolio approach, it gives us a chance to put together like projects and improve our corporate knowledge and look for other opportunities where we can put together multiple good ideas to be more impactful, to do more for the nation. And so I think that's really the power of the portfolio approach, that we can do more than just run an excellent single project, but we can think how those projects go together, and we can help better shape the thinking of our sponsor base. And again, further build on the great things that GTRI does. The sensors portfolio has three areas, but then, none of the portfolios are, mutually orthogonal. So the three key areas in sensors are intelligence, surveillance, and reconnaissance, or what we call ISR, electronic warfare, and autonomy. Those are the three sub areas. But a close cousin to all this is the air and missile defense work. So air and missile defense falls in the systems portfolio, but a lot of air and missile defense are the large radar systems. So when you look at least the three areas, ISR, ISR includes important areas like building airborne or spaceborne platforms to collect strategic information that informs the warfighter on what the adversary might be doing, but increasingly taking those sensors and coupling them to rapid tactical responses. Electronic warfare is very broad for us. It can include electronic attack, jamming systems, but the reason it's in the sensor portfolio is a big part of our heritage centers around anti-jam capability, or what we call electronic protection. So we want to build these robust systems and then make sure we can protect them from being jammed, from losing information. And so it turns out electronic attack and electronic protection really go together, because you can't really be good at jamming things if you don't know how they can be protected. You can't really be good at protecting things unless you know how to jam them. And so this is kind of this virtuous cycle between the two areas. The last area is autonomy or intelligence systems. So, we envision a world where we take all these sensors and electronic warfare systems and we let them collaborate on missions, and they share information and they share their worldview and they work together so that all of the different elements can create a greater effect than any single system. And so, we have a number of activities in that area which include collaborative autonomy algorithms and behaviors, collaborative autonomy enabling architectures, and field test and evaluation. And for all the areas, we do a lot of everything from theory through getting our hands dirty, going to the field, working with real systems, and doing the prototyping as well. I love the work at GTRI, and the reason I came here, as I explained when I was a young captain leaving the Air Force, is the same reason I stay here. It's about the technology and the work that we do. And a great thing about GTRI that we really need to embrace is the entrepreneurial spirit. It's important to do really good technical work. It's also really important to understand the sponsor needs and have that can-do attitude and go solve important problems and propose new ideas. And I think that's what our researchers love about GTRI, and I think that's what keeps them here as well. And so there's no want of important problems to solve. The government needs good ideas, they need innovation, and without being over dramatic, we're facing some trying times. The world is as dangerous a place as it's ever been, and GTRI will be called upon in the future to solve some important problems for national defense. There's no doubt. All you have to do is read the news to understand that. So in addition to all the great work we do, I think we bear the burden of heavy responsibility. And I think that, that will grow, and I think each of us has to take that responsibility seriously.